free audio library.
Hi, subscribers and viewers of our Ubi channel. I welcome you back to my channel once more. So in this video, I'm going to show you folks a kind of access point you can deploy at your home, and it's a product from Ubiquiti. It's a very good product called the AirCube. This is how the AirCube looks like, and on the web user interface, this is how it appears on your computer. In this case, I'm not actually unboxing this AirCube, but I'm trying to introduce it to my viewers and subscribers. For those who don't know about this device, to have some fair knowledge about it. And those who know should just refresh their memory about this device. Okay, so that's the purpose of this particular video. With much ado, let's move on. And so this is how the device looks like. Very nice, very slick, and very beautiful. And it has an interface. It has an application on your mobile as well, so you can either view it on your mobile phone or on a computer. If we move on, let's get into some details about this AirCube. So AirCube is an AirMAX device, okay? So AirMAX home Wi-Fi access point with PoE in and out. This PoE in and out means it can be powered using a PoE adapter or a PoE switch instead of using a power adapter. The same way it can power a different device, okay, with a PoE out. Maybe if you have another PoE enabled device, instead of giving it power directly, this device can power it on. So these are the models: ACB, AirCube AC, and AirCube ISP. So these are two models. These are two models we are going to discuss about today. A PoE passthrough for powering. So it's a 24 volt CPE device. Okay. And it's managed by unms, you know, user manager, Ubiquiti, management system, Ubiquiti network management system. Yes, you know, it has an app for fast setup from a mobile device as well. So this device can also act as a CPE, okay, for clients. Okay, so introduction. Examples of a typical deployment. So this is how, let me kindly go through the introduction. Ubiquiti Networks introduces the AirCube, a cost-effective wireless access point for use in your customer deployments. Wireless performance. Two models are available: the AirCube AC dual band. Thus, it uses 802.11ac protocol, Wi-Fi protocol, and is a MIMO 2x2 MIMO technology for maximum wireless performance. And it has two Wi-Fi bands, that's 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz dual band. The 2.4 has a speed of up to 300 megabytes per second, and the 5 GHz radio band has a speed of up to 866.7 megabits per second. The AirCube ISP, which is the other model, is also an 802.11n Wi-Fi technology, and is also a 2.2 MIMO Wi-Fi, and it has a speed of up to 300 megabits per second in the 2.4 GHz radio band. The versatile power options. Both models offer convenient PoE pass-through to power a 24-volt airMAX CP device. So you can use a single PoE adapter to power both devices. So it's as simple as that. And this is a typical scenario of its deployment. So as you can see, this is a base station, and on the base station, a rocket with sector antenna has been mounted. This is it, and it's been directed. So it's a base station, okay, and we have a nano beam CP deployed at a client's premises. Now, the nano beam CP is being directed. It's rather being directed to the. To the base station, okay, it's not the other way around. And then the AirCube is being used. So after the nano beam receives a signal, we have a cable from the nano beam directly connecting to the AirCube, and then you can start having access to your internet or your other services, okay. So in this case, it says, so it says point-to-multi-point link. The AirCube powers a nano beam 5AC generation 2 CP, which connects to a rocket prism 5AC gen 2 on an airMAX AC sector antenna. So this explains what I just said. So if we go further, we've spoken about the power over Ethernet, and then the 24 volts power input. Now this is its intuitive software. This is the management screen. On the management screen, this is how it typically looks like on your desktops and laptops, and on your mobile phones, this is how it typically looks like. Okay, so basically this is how the intuitive software, which is the management screens, work on your devices in this way, trying to manage the device. So intuitive software management options feature a graphical user interface designed for streamlined setup and control. Available options include unms, provides advanced remote control of Ubiquiti devices. Use the unms app to manage your devices using a tablet or smartphone. Web user interface, that's web UI, enables a standalone utility for basic configuration. Okay, okay, so these are the models, these are the design, these are our it looks like, you know, very nice. These are the ports. So this is the AirCube AC. It has about 4 gigabit ports, and the port with the blue color around it is dedicated to the internet or one. So it has about 4 gigabit Ethernet ports. Of course, it is 24 volt PoE pass through. It has a dual band and has a 802.11ac Wi-Fi technology. It is 2x2 MIMO technology. It has up to 300 megabits per second in 2.4 gigahertz radio band. It has up to 866.7 megabits per second in 5 gigahertz radio band. You know, this is it with AirCube AC. Okay, now let's move on to the second one, which is the AirCube ISP. AirCube ISP has also four ports, fast Ethernet ports, Ethernet gigabit ports. Okay, it also has a 24 volt PoE pass through for AirMAX CP, and it has 802.11n Wi-Fi technology. It's also 2x2 MIMO technology, and it has a single band of 2.4 GHz radio band, which has a speed of up to 300 megabits per second. Okay, so that's the difference between AirCube AC and AirCube ISP. So here you can see the model comparison chart, and it gives you details of it. Okay. Okay, this talks about the specification of the AirCube AC. This is more about the design of the product, the weight, the power supply, the power method, the supported power voltage, maximum power consumption, PoE out, management interface, networking interface, LED, maximum transmit power. Okay, so this is about 23 dBm on the 5 GHz and 19 dBm on the 2.4 GHz. Wow. So the antenna gain on 2.4 GHz is 4 dBi. Maximum speed is 2.4 on 2.4 GHz is 300 Mbps, which has been spoken already. With the 5 GHz, it has 5 dBi and also a speed of 866.7 Mbps, which has been spoken already. It talks about the enclosure characteristics, ESD, EMP protection, operating temperature, operating humidity certifications. Okay, so this is how it looks like. Same with the AirCube ISP, you know, same thing, talks about the antenna gain, the maximum transmit power, and all those other ones. Okay, so this is it with AirCube. So we basically spoke about two particular models, which is the AirCube AC and AirCube ISP, and we spoke about the differences between them. But God willing, by tomorrow I will make a video about it, about how to configure it, and then upload it for folks to have a feel of it and have some fair idea of how it works in the actual sense of it. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please like this video, share, and please subscribe so that you can see more videos I'll be uploading on this channel. Thank you very much for watching. Free Audio Library.